A man-made pond in the middle of a park. It's beautiful and it's pristine, and we want to keep it that way, which means somewhere there are dozens of human beings whose job it is to keep this clean. But this pond has a unique way of returning that favor. Fresh water is essential to human life, which is why a large portion of our infrastructure is devoted to creating and delivering fresh water to cities, just like the ancient Romans built their giant aqueducts to bring water to theirs. You could say that without fresh water, cities are virtually impossible to maintain. But where there are a large number of human beings, there is also a large amount of human poop, which is frankly excellent at contaminating drinking water and spreading disease. You may have heard that in the oldie days, they would throw their waste out of second-story windows onto the road, and that some houses had overhangs like this to allow people a safe place to walk underneath. Those stories are largely a myth, and that didn't really happen. But the waste did have to go somewhere, and it is dangerous. As the Map Man chronicled in this video here, one baby's diapers was enough to create a cholera outbreak in London. And human feces is more dangerous than animal dung. Cow plop is often used as fertilizer and so forth, but human waste is far more likely to contain dangerous chemicals like arsenic and mercury, and also the types of diseases and parasites that are best equipped for hurting human beings. That's why campers are told to bury their waste, even though every other animal in the woods is just leaving theirs lie wherever it falls. Cities needed a better way to deal with this, hence the modern sewage system. Today, our cities sit atop a large network of tunnels and sewers designed to take the waste away from our homes. In fact, this development is so important that we have gone to amazing lengths in order to make it happen. Starting in 1858, the entire city of Chicago was raised up several feet to allow sewers to be installed underneath it. Yes, the entire city, building by building, street by street, was jacked up permanently several feet. They even transported a couple of multi-story buildings out into the suburbs, the show-offs. If I was the sort of person who was inclined to make up fantastic stories and try to pass them off as real, this is exactly the sort of thing that I would make up. So now, when you flush, your waste is taken away, out of sight, out of mind, out of body. But of course, it does have to go somewhere. Enter waste treatment plants. Large, smelly, usually far away from the city because no one wants to be near them. There is a growing trend lately to desire a better solution than this. Some people just want to reclaim the land and use it for other things. Others are looking to get rid of the smell, and some are worried about the chemicals they use to treat it. But for whatever the reason, people are looking for better solutions. So what are they? You may have heard of the LifeStraw, a device that can take foul and polluted water and quickly turn it into something you can drink. It's something you can buy here, but its main use is in developing worlds that don't have the same access to sewage that we have here. And in those countries, it is literally a lifesaver. This brings us to a remarkable idea. This pond, like hundreds of others that are cropping up all across the southern United States, has the goals of moving waste treatment closer to the source, using municipal lands more efficiently, reducing smell, and reducing the use of chemicals. This man-made pond is sitting on top of a giant hollow fiber membrane filter, the same type developed for the LifeStraw. The sewage from the local areas is pumped up through it, and it emerges clean, safe, and subjectively beautiful. This pond can process about 100,000 gallons a day, which is way less than massive treatment plants But these are also much less of an eyesore, so city planners may find them easier to incorporate into their designs. This is humanity at its finest. We took something dangerous and disgusting, and we made it beautiful. And that is the sort of idea I want to spend a lot of time exploring.